and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen.
Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee, and worthily magnify thy holy name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And that we and all has
subjects, duly considering whose authority ye have, may faithfully serve, honour and humbly obey her, in thee and for thee, according to thy blessed word and ordinance. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee and the Holy Ghost, liveth and reigneth ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Almighty God, who hast given us thine only begotten Son, to take our nature upon him, and as at this time to be born of a pure virgin, grant that we, being regenerate and made thy children by adoption and grace, may daily be renewed by thy Holy Spirit. Through the same our Lord Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the same Spirit, ever one God, world without end.
Scripture appointed for the epistle is written in the fifth chapter of the book of the prophet Micah. But thou, Bethlehem Ephratah, though thou be little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of thee shall he come forth unto me that is to be ruler in Israel, whose goings forth have been from of old, from everlasting. Therefore will he give them up until the time that she which travaileth hath brought forth. Then the remnant of his brethren shall return unto the children of Israel. And he shall stand and feed in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall abide. For now shall he be great unto the ends of the earth. Here endeth the lesson.
Thank you.
the continuation of the Holy Gospel, according to Saint Luke. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, the God of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God, very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate, and he suffered and was buried. And the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of He shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe in the Holy Catholic Church, and acknowledge from my presence for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Would you please sit down? Lovely to welcome you here to Chapel World for our slightly scaled down midnight mass. It's lovely to be in this place worshipping in these difficult times. We pray for God's peace in our lives and in the lives of this nation and in the world at this time. May I speak in the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen.
The plunging of our city and much of the southeast, firstly into Tier 3 and then only a few days later into Tier 4, has naturally caused quite a bit of disruption. Not only have many of us found ourselves having to rethink very quickly Christmas arrangements and travel, but for those who, like me, tend to leave their Christmas shopping to the very end, it's a man thing I gather, this has really scuppered proceedings. As well as the ubiquitous Amazon and eBay purchases, I rather love pottering around the little shops, especially those one finds over the road, to discover those unexpected treasures that will either delight or bemuse those for whom they have been bought. Being a man, of course, this is, as I say, a last-minute exercise, which has a certain frisson when those treasures are not quite as easily as forthcoming as they might be. But none of that this year. With those shops, and indeed also the eBay window firmly closed, all hope of procuring those late gifts has been firmly dashed. I can't even buy them sprouts. The only consolation is, I suppose, that there are not going to be any guests to give presents to anyway. However, whilst I was looking, one thing did catch the eye, which in another world would have been perfect for a rather irreverent friend of mine. It was a t-shirt which had a nativity scene on it, and then underneath the words, spoiler alert, he dies. It did strike me that it was rather appropriate for this, the most surreal and, let's say, less than ideal Christmases in this most surreal and dismal of years. And with yet another lockdown looming round the corner, with people living in fear and confusion, loneliness and isolation, I suspect that most people's thoughts are very far from the traditional comfort and joy of the warm manger. But that is precisely the point. He dies. Yes, that may sound incredibly morbid at first, but as we are reminded in several ancient and less ancient carols, the wood of the cross is not all that far from the wood of the crib. That very first Christmas did not exactly take place in a five-star hotel or an ideal birthing suite. The world into which the baby Jesus was born was far from being peaceful and calm, but was rather volatile and dangerous. The Christ child, that is, God made human, came into the confusion and complexity of the human nature and existence, not just playing a part as an actor, but truly living as a real and true human being. Far from being distant, then, God was and is in the midst of it all, knowing and feeling what it was to be vulnerable, placing himself indeed at the mercy of other human beings. The heartwarming truth of the Christmas story, however it may have worked out on that night, is not one of a grand cosmic display of angels or a great display of God's power, but rather that God became an ordinary human being, so that ordinary human beings would become one day like God. We call this the incarnation, meaning that from the very moment of human experience it became God's as well. The vulnerability of that tiny baby, that make-do crib, the smell of the animals, the coldness of the winter night, the having to make the best out of a very bad situation. All these very everyday things, for us, have been canonized, have been made holy by God being in the midst of and experiencing them. Or to put it another way, God knows what it is to be us. Spoiler alert, he dies. What then could be more prescient for this particular time? Not just in the sense of a gallows or trench humour that we're all getting used to and frankly is getting us through all of this. Yes, this is for everyone here, not Christmas any one of us would have wanted to celebrate. But in our not wanting to do it that particular way, this way, In fact, we are possibly celebrating it far closer to the source than we may have done. This year, we cannot avoid the fact that death has been all around us, whether reported daily in the media or through the loss of a loved one in some cases. We have, to a certain extent, all been challenged in our assumptions that we can just avoid it all, push it under the carpet, as it were. But as the Christ child shows, in coming to live a genuine human life, God also came eventually to die as well. And that wouldn't be a mark of his failure, but the ultimate act of solidarity with all those who in one way or another suffer. And at the moment, that can be in all manner of ways. The comfort and joy of Christmas is then not simply about having procured enough food, drink, presents or Brussels sprouts, having the perfect gathering or the perfect decorations. Whilst yes, these matter because we want it to be good, the reason behind it matters far more. No, the comfort and joy of Christmas is that love came down into the world in order to make the world a more lovely place. The greatest gift from God is not just celebrated in one day in the year and gone the next. It is that legacy that whatever might happen and whatever unexpected woe may lie around the corner, we are not alone. For God is there with us. Perhaps then this year, we have a reason to look to what Christmas is really about. Despite the headlines and what people might say, it is in no way cancelled. It is rather that our keeping of it has changed. The love that brings people together at Christmas is no less because they cannot be in the same room or building. Indeed, perhaps it is even more. Since when the day comes when we are liberated from all things to do with coronavirus, we will see our loved ones in a new light. Remember, absence makes the heart grow fonder, for we take them less granted as well. How can we be assured of this? Well, the spoiler alert is that he dies. But he rises again. As God became human in the birth of Jesus, so in return, humans become God with him. Death is not the end. The darkness can never overwhelm the light, even if that light appears at times very small. Remember, the light shining in the darkness, a single light, actually seems stronger. And for us, here tonight, that light is the light of love. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven.
Lord, see, Lord, the day is near.
our prayers tonight, we pray for the peace of the world, for all nations and all Christians who come together to greet the newborn Christ child. We pray for those who suffer, for the refugees, the homeless, the sick, for those who mourn, for those who are alone, for those who, for whom this Christmas will be a difficult time. We pray that the love of Christ may come into all our hearts, and that we may be renewed in our hope, that we may work for the coming of the kingdom. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and to receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty. Beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all they that do confess thy very name may agree in the truth of thy very word and live in unity and godliness. We beseech thee also to save and defend all Christian kings, princes, and governors, and especially thy servant Elizabeth our Queen, that under her we may be godly and quietly governed. And grant unto her whole counsel, and to all that are put in authority under her, that they may truly and indifferently minister justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and curates, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and specially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all them who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Ye that do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbours, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy means, draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, meekly kneeling upon your knees. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, may we make of all things judge of all men. We acknowledge and prevail on manifold sins of rudeness, which we from time to time as we visit our committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty. Provoke you most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do learn us to repent, and our hearts be sorry for these our mysteries. Remember us of them that we have done to us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, and his merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in his name of God, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life
through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John said. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who art thy
thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made dead by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, we thy humble servants entirely desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy and lively sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that all we who are partakers of this holy communion may be fulfilled by grace and heavenly benediction. And although we be unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offences through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honour and glory be unto thee.
O Father Almighty, world without end.
Behold the Lamb of God that takest away the sins of the world. Thank you. which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries, with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favour and goodness towards us. And that in our very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. And we most humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honour and glory, world without end.
Amen.
Thank you.
Holy God, our Heavenly Father, who on this night thy only Son, Jesus Christ, was born of the Virgin Mary, for us and for our salvation, bless, we pray, this crib, which we have prepared to celebrate that holy birth. May all who see it be strengthened in faith and receive the fullness of life that he came to bring, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end. You this night and forevermore.
Amen. Amen.